Welcome to the end of the month 8-ball tournaments for June 2016. In this match, we have Rob Wright versus Peter Hsu. We've taken two games from the match. It's interesting because these two games are pretty well chess matches, and it outlines how each opponent thinks when it comes to playing chess. Lots of defensive and offensive strategies here, lots of tactics that could be of interest to people who are wondering about how to play chess on the pool table. Not that Peter's any better at this than anybody, but Peter does play real chess, and sometimes chess thinking comes to play when Peter is on the pool table. Anyways, Rob is running the table right now, and there's really no reason why Rob shouldn't run this table. The only problem ball might be the 15, which is on the left long rail, because Rob needs to get to it, and the ball is screened by the 5 and is blocked by the 2 on the long rail, so Rob can only shoot to the bottom left pocket, and he needs to get the cue ball there, and he almost does it. He overshoots on the cue ball, and he will not get the ball, but he will go off the rail, I believe. Yes, no cigar, but Rob's ball is now in a very bad spot. It sees no pocket, and Peter will use this opportunity to sink his balls down and either try to break it out or get Rob to break it out, and or better still, hook Rob so he can get the ball in hand. But meanwhile, Peter will start sinking balls. I think in the back of Peter's mind is shooting 2 and calling a safety, but only later in the game. Oops, he knocked into the 2 by accident. I don't think he meant to bump into the 2, because he's pretty well hooked himself, except for the 2. Now Peter considers shooting the 2 with bottom, but Rob basically says that shot requires a ref to ref, because the distance between the 2 balls is less than a chalk's width. So he will call a ref in case I do want to shoot the 2 ball down the rail to the bottom left corner. Anyways, Peter feels the shot is doable. He's done it many times before successfully without double hitting. And Ron comes to assess the situation. Peter shows him what he was going to do. Peter asks if the shot is doable, but Ron cannot answer, because it's against the rules for the ref to answer any questions. So Peter plays safety, hooking Rob. It looks like a solid hook. There's no way. There's no way Rob could hit the ball, and even if he did, it would be undesirable, because he would be breaking out the 5 for Peter, and that's the last thing Rob wants to do. So Rob will now try to mess up the layout for Peter, make it harder for Peter to run out. So he's actually looking at the 8 ball. What Rob's gonna do is try to block a pocket with the 8. So he decides to go for the bottom right corner. And in fact, he does. He gives ball in hand to Peter, but the sixth ball, which is on the bottom right next to the eight ball, is no longer shootable. It's effectively blocked by the eight ball, even though the blockage is very small. There's no guarantee Peter will get it in, even with ball in hand. Now, Peter could shoot the sixth ball away from the eight, but he sees no pocket. So Peter will figure, well, he'll shoot a couple more balls down and then free the six. So one ball down. Peter does have the advantage here because he has more balls than Rob, and in this way he can control the table. He can decide whether to hook Rob, go for a breakout, or play it safe. He decides to break the six out, and the six blocks the eight, which may or may not be a good thing because the two balls are so closely, they're so close that it'll be difficult for Peter to do anything with the six. Rob does a very brilliant shot. He hooks Peter and forces Peter to shoot at the six. Peter does successfully and hooks Rob. Rob will now try to hit his 15 ball. But Peter does have a problem. His six is in a really weird spot. You'd pretty well need ball in hand to do anything with it. And his two and five. Okay, they're pretty bad balls now. Not much Peter can do with them. So Peter will go for a hook. He's gonna clip the five and leave the cue ball behind the two. And that was a good shot. Rob calls for a bank off the rail. Almost does it. And Peter decides to go for a hook, sinking the five. Now, whether sinking the five or just leaving it over the pocket, that's an open question. Peter hasn't really figured it out yet, but he figured, well, why not sink the five, because he's gonna get a solid hook out of it anyways. So, and Peter has a nice hook. I don't think the eight will go into the corner. I think Rob took a look at it. It's quite possible the six is blocking it, but we're not sure. But anyways, Rob still needs to hit his ball. Checks the eight ball again. Does it go in? Oh, another brilliant shot by Rob. He blocks the six. So even with ball in hand, Peter doesn't have much to work with. Peter needs ball in hand to take out the two. And the problem with the eight ball is it's very open for Rob to shoot. So Peter can't give Rob ball in hand right now. So Peter will go for another hook and push the six ball over the corner. That's a pretty good shot. Rob will not make an attempt on his 15 ball. That would be suicide. So what Rob's gonna do is mess up the layout for Peter again. And another brilliant shot by Rob. Ball in hand for Peter. Does he know he have ball in hand? Nope. Peter's been getting so many ball in hands, he totally forgets he has ball in hand. Come on, Peter, wake up. Oh no, he's gonna try to hit. Peter forgot he's got ball in hand. Oh man, this is so bad. I can't believe he's not taking ball in hand. Oh God. Well, Peter's plan is to clip the six and leave the cue ball all the way down. Man, this is agony watching not take ball in hand, take ball in, oh God. Ooh, tragedy. The cue ball hit the horn, middle pocket, and gives Rob a perfect shot on his 15. Rob tells Peter, why the hell didn't you take ball in hand? And Peter says, I forgot. Oh well. Rob takes the game, but it's a very interesting take on how an A-plus player like Rob thinks when it comes to playing chess. Anyways, this is chess match number 2. And the score is now 2-2. This is A-side still. Both Rob and Peter are racing to 4 to stay on A-side. Rob breaks and I assume Rob's gonna take high ball. It looks like the easiest. The only problem is high ball has the 15 again trapped on the left rail just under the 7, but Rob's gonna figure out how to break it out using the 12, which is near the side pocket. That would be a very good ball, very good breakout ball. So Rob will now try to get the cue ball to move into breakout position. Well, except he didn't quite do it. He did not miss. I'm very certain Rob didn't miss. I think what Rob was doing was creating another secondary breakout ball. And Peter voices his suspicion, you know. I can't believe you missed that shot. It has a lot of purpose to that miss. So Peter is on to Rob's thinking. So, but the layout favors Peter for sure. His 3 and 2 are shootable to the bottom left corner. The only problem might be the 7, but the 7 is open enough that in an event of a breakout, it should move towards the side pocket. And it's not obscured or anything. Anyways, Peter decides to take the 2 and wait for his chance to do a breakout. And he's being very careful not to miss and give Rob the breakout angle. He's gonna take the 6 and, all right, now he's gonna take the 5, but he also wants to knock in the 10. At this point, having more balls on the table actually favors the player, and Peter realizes this, and he knows that because Rob has a very bad 15 ball, Peter's going to try to kill Rob's ducks. Peter knocks Rob's secondary breakout ball away, the 14, and now he's going to try to kill the 10. Yeah, he killed the 10, but he didn't sink his 5 ball, which may be bad. But Rob does have a good breakout angle. He can't use a lot of power here. The 14 is now a problem ball. Rob realizes that, so he could break it out, but he still needs to break out the 14. So he elects to break out the 14 first. Very nice shot. Peter doesn't have a pocket for anything. So it's a very safety game. Lots of critical thinking. Peter is determined not to give Rob the breakout angle. So, Rob can take out the 12, but by doing so, he will have robbed himself of the breakout ball. So Rob's not taking the bait. And Rob starts to kill Peter's ball. Now, the only shot Peter has is this 7. He's forced to break out Rob's 15 for Rob. Peter is careful not to break out his ball. He avoids a ball in hand and kicks out the 7. Now, Rob can pocket the 12, but there's really no purpose for that. He needs the 12 to do breakouts. Anyways, Rob is starting to... He traded ball in hand for killing my duck. Now, without my 7, it's virtually impossible to do any breakouts. Now, Peter decides he will kill one of Rob's ducks. So which duck shall Peter kill? He could kill the 12, thus cheating Rob of his breakout ball, or he could take out the 14 and give Rob ball in hand and hope Rob will do a breakout. But breakouts are tricky. Sometimes it favors the opponent. And so Peter decides to go that way. He's going to give Rob ball in hand. He'll first kill the 14, and Rob gets ball in hand, and Rob will attempt for a breakout. Or will he? He decides to do something else. Rob decides to put some space between his ball and the 5. This way, when he does get ball in hand, he can take out the 15. Now Peter cannot give Rob ball in hand. What he'll try to do is kill the duck, the 12. Unfortunately, all Peter did was park the 12 over a pocket, and Rob is energized. He smells blood. His first instinct is to sink the 15 and then go for the ducky 12 by the corner, but for some strange mysterious reason unknown to Peter, Rob decides to take the 12 instead. I think Rob's very confident of his shooting. He feels that he can bring the cue ball all the way down to the 15 and go from there, but he overshoots and hooks himself. And he goes for the chess game again. Ball in hand for Peter. But Peter has a big advantage here. He can hook Rob and kick out the 15. Except he didn't kick out the 15 far enough, Rob can still bank and get the 15. Well, I think Rob miscued. He had to shoot off the rail, and he glanced on the cue ball. So Peter gets ball in hand. And Peter has an easy shot on the 5, giving him position on the 8. It's been a very intensive chess game. Anyways, Peter wins the next one to take the match from Rob Wright. Great shooting, Rob.